In today's video, I'm going to share ideas for color inspiration for your quilt projects with you. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts, and there are lots and lots of places you can find inspiration for colors to use in your quilt projects, and I want to share some of those ideas with you in today's video. So, one of the first places you can get inspiration for colors for your quilts is at quilt shows. So, when you go to quilt shows, take notice of the quilts that really catch your eye. And for me, it's usually the colors in them that are attracting me first and then the design. You may be different, but that's what I notice. So if there are ones that you really like the colors they've combined in those quilts, make sure you take a few photos of them. You got your iPhone, right? So then you can analyze those when you come home and see how you can use them in your own projects. Now there's some other things I want to suggest to you as well, and those are magazines. So quilting magazines, for example. So in this particular one, which is from QuiltCon, 2022, there are all these different pictures of quilts, okay? So I'm not at the show, but I'm looking at photos of quilts that were at the show. And this particular one really caught my eye. It's Sudoku, and it's from Charles Cameron. And even if you look at just some of the blocks in this particular quilt, you can see the colors he has combined. Some of those might really catch your eye. I like the purple and red here against the black. It really shines. So looking at different quilt books can give you ideas for projects. Here's another one from Fresh Quilts from a few years ago, and this is actually a project in the book here. This is a table runner, long distance runner, by Linda Aldridge. And again, look at the colors she's combined in here. You've got the yellow, the blues, the kind of lime greens, and these kind of oranges. So a really fresh looking palette. Kind of reminds me of guacamole with some salsa or something, actually. And then one of my favorite magazines is Love, Patchwork, and Quilting. And this issue from a few years ago has this particular project in it called Print Spin. And I'm liking these pinks and kind of sort of salmon with the black again. And then these blue kind of aqua shades. You can see the overall effect here really stands out. I love aqua, so you know, this kind of really caught my eye. So when you're looking at projects in books and magazines, take a look at what colors they're putting together and see, you know, if those are something that you really enjoy and want to use in your own quilts. And then of course, if you actually have some fabric that you want to add other fabrics to, you know those dots on the selvage, right? Those are the colors used to make this particular piece of fabric, and those are ones that you can take with you to either your stash or your local quilt store and pick up some, or you know, you probably don't want all of them depending on what kind of quilt you're making, but some of the colors that will go really nicely with the particular fabric that you are using. So those are some quilt related resources for you, but there's inspiration all around you too, and some places you might not even think of looking. So let's talk about that. And keeping with the idea of magazines, let's take a look at this one. This is Lee Valley. Love going to Lee Valley. And even on the front here, you can see the different colors of the Christmas balls that they have on here. These kind of pinks, the greens, the blues together, the darker colors, the red. Really, I really like that combination of colors. I think it looks great. And even when I went inside the magazine, got to think outside the box here, this little scrubbing pad, one of which I actually have, but not in this color, in these colors, you can see all the different colors they've got in there too. That'd make a really fun, kind of a spring-like quilt, I think, with those bright colors, with the greens and aquas and the light pink and the yellow colors in those too. So when you're going through magazines, take a look at some of the ads or some of the products in them, and you might find some interesting ideas for a color palette for your quilts. And speaking of other kinds of magazines, I don't tend to buy other magazines other than quilting ones, actually. But if you are someone who buys home decorating magazines, take a look at the different photos in there, because they are showing you how to how to set up your rooms. But they're also looking at the colors they're combining in those rooms. They want them to be harmonious and look good, right? Now, if you don't buy those magazines, not to worry, because they have websites. So, for example, the other day I typed in home decorating trends 2023, and what came up with was a list of different sites, of course, and one of the ones I looked at was House Beautiful. And in there they'll have different articles. Again, they're looking at what you can do, what were the trends are that you can do in your different rooms in your house for this year. When I'm recording this, it's 2023, and I wasn't so much interested in those trends, but I was interested in the colors they were using in those rooms. And so in this one picture, you can see the subtle color palette that's going on in those curtains, which, by the way, might actually be a great modern quilt design, as you can see. It's kind of a twofer in those curtains. And then there was another picture that really caught my eye, and this was bringing the backyard into your house. I wasn't looking at the room so much, but I was looking at the gorgeous color of aqua in the pool and the luscious greens in the grass and shrubs around there. Throw in some white in there, and I think you've got a great modern color palette. Now, besides magazine websites online, there are different color generators online. You might find some of these through paint companies, or one site that I like to use is called Coolors, C-O-O-L-O-R-S, and this is actually a color palette generator. So you can have different colors that come up, usually about five of them that will come up. Automatically, all you do is push the space bar, it generates a whole new color palette. So it's fun to play with. And then when you come up with these different colors that you really like, you could take a screenshot of those and use those to pick fabrics for your next quilt project. It's a free website. There is another level that you would have to pay for, but the free one works perfectly well for what we want to use it for, which is to pick colors for our quilts. Now, what about things you may have right under your nose in your own home that you see every day and never really think about? I've got a few examples from my own home here. So, for example, I have this vase that I've had for years, and you can see it's got this subtle color palette. You've got the greens, the blues, two different shades of blues, and kind of like a salmon color in there is a little pop. A really nice subtle color palette, be a great color palette for a man's quilt. I hate to see a man's quilt, but you know what I'm saying, not a real floral type, you know, bright colored kind of quilt, but just nice subtle blues and greens kind of a quilt. And then I have this little, it's going to make noise here, so I'll take the lid off, this little jewelry box here. And this I got in an antique store because I really liked the design on it. And I love the aqua in here. There's kind of some light pinks in here as well, and the reds. I love aqua and pink together. So I really like this. And then you've got some kind of orange or even like a soft kind of yellow orange color in it, hard to say, but it's very harmonious looking. But you've got these pops of the red and the blue in there, so I think this would make a really nice quilt as well. And then if you want to go something really much brighter, this is a bowl I brought back from Mexico. It's not Talavera, but it looks very similar to it. But again, you've got these bright colors, the yellows, oranges, reds, blues, greens. There's a lot of different colors in there and different variations of some of those colors, the lighter blue, kind of almost an aqua here, and then the dark navy in some of these flowers here, the reds, yellow, and orange, all kind of a similar warm color scheme. So you could pick some of the colors, you don't pick all of them, but some of the colors in here might be just what you're looking for one of your quilt colors. So the next time you're thinking about choosing colors for your quilt, take a look around you. Think outside the box, outside the quilting world, and I'm sure you'll come up with lots of different ideas. And speaking of ideas, if you have other things that you look towards, you know, if there's other suggestions you have for where you find colors for your quilts, please put them in the comments below because I'd love to know how you get your color inspiration. In this video, I've shared some ideas for you where you can find color inspiration for your quilts. But there's another thing that I didn't talk about, and that is the color wheel. Now, if you don't know how to use a color wheel to pick certain color schemes for your quilts, don't worry, I've got you covered. Make sure you check out this video I've included just for you, and it will give you all the information that you need. For more helpful quilting information, be sure to go to my website at www.chatterboxquilts.com.